Hello and welcome to CBA News in Brief. My name is Ongoing Nguhe. Somali President Mohamed Farmajo used his inaugural address to the United Nations General Assembly on Thursday to reject Kenya's call for talks on the maritime boundary dispute. The two countries are fighting over the maritime boundary in the Indian Ocean. President Mohamed Abdullahi Farmajo said the matter was in court and that the International Court of Justice should be the ultimate arbiter because talks between the two countries have collapsed completely. He further said that Somalia will comply with the court's final judgment and accept the outcome of the boundary that is delimited by the court. The firm talking president added that as a matter of international law, the court's judgment will be binding on Kenya as well. President Uhuru Kenyatta had earlier said he was open to anything, though emphasizing on dialogue as the best option to find a solution. Somalia's president also rejected the African Union's push for dialogue, touted as African solutions for African problems. The African Union chairman, Egypt's president Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, had brokered talks between the two leaders on Tuesday evening on the sidelines of the UN General Assembly convention in New York, in which Somalia and Kenya said was the first step to normalize relations. The United Arab Emirates has announced that it will be expanding Bosaso Airport, the regional capital of Bari. A delegation from UAE visited the airport and toured the different departments of the airport. The visiting Abu Dhabi authorities have said that construction is expected to begin soon in the port city of Bosaso. Puntland Minister of Civil Aviation and Airport Hussein Osman Lugator told reporters that the airport is preparing to be one of the best airports in the region, providing adequate services. The president of Puntland State of Somalia, Said Abdullahi Deni, on the other hand, defended the decision to hand over control of the Bosaso Airport, saying the country needed investment to develop no matter where it comes from. Although the Puntland president did not name the company, he expressed confidence that the company will have the financial strength to invest in the airport and attract international flights to Puntland. The exact date of the planned expansion of Bosaso Airport has not yet been announced. In other news, the African Union mission, AMISOM, in Baidoa, Somalia, held a medal parade for outgoing Ethiopian National Defense Force troops who have completed their tour of duty. The officers were honored with merit awards from the African Union Mission Leadership, Federal Government of Somalia, the Organization of Southwest States, Women and Community Elders for their contribution to peace and security during their deployment. Southwest State President Abdiaziz Mohamed Laughter Green said the AMISOM forces in Baidoa had succeeded in protecting the lives and properties of the people of Southwest, citing the neutralization of a vehicle-borne improvised explosive device early this year when terrorists attempted to attack Bader Town. The Special Representative of the African Union Commission Chairperson for Somalia, Ambassador Francisco Madeira, said by sending troops to serve under AMISOM, the Ethiopian government had shown its commitment to peace and stability in the region. Qatar has called on all parties in Somalia to renounce differences and work together to move forward in the political process, strengthen efforts to consolidate national reconciliation, fight corruption, and promote human rights and fundamental freedoms. Qatar has also called on the international community and all partners to coordinate efforts to provide technical assistance and capacity building, as well as financial support for the development of Somalia institutions, especially those concerned with human rights, in addition to continuing to provide relief assistance and funding humanitarian response plans. Consultant at the Human Rights Department at the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, Dr. Turki Al-Mahmoud, pointed out that the state of Qatar will host the meeting of the contact group of the Organization of Islamic Cooperation, OIC, on Somalia at the ministerial level on October 27th this year. Al-Mahmoud noted the state of Qatar's commitment to respect the sovereignty, independence, unity, and territorial integrity of Somalia. Senegal's Sufi Mouride Brotherhood has on Friday inaugurated a mosque that can hold 30,000 worshippers, described as the largest in West Africa in the capital Dakar. Work on the Masalikul Jinan Mosque, which means the path to paradise, began a decade ago on land donated by the government. The mosque has a capacity of 15,000 worshippers inside and another 15,000 in an outside esplanade. Officials from the Brotherhood say the cost exceeded $33 million, all of which came from donations. Its name is derived from the title of a poem by Sheikh Ahmadou Bamba, the 19th century founder of the Brotherhood. Thank you for watching CBN News in Brief. Join Eunice Deko later tonight with more detailed news.